Are they even?
Ish.
It could very well be that they kind of make a pukey baby. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. Today, another multiple neutral looks video with a colorful palette. I'm not saying that correctly. So today another video in my neutral looks with a colorful palette series. Let's do it like that. If you are new here, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm almost 44 and I love colorful makeup. However, I found that kind of late last year, I was beginning to gravitate more and more towards brown shades. And why do I say that? Because neutrals for me are brown shades, the rest is color. So please let me know down in the comment section what you consider to be neutral looks or neutral colors, because everything that is not a brown in my eyes is color. So it will help me out a lot if you would let me know what you consider to be neutral shades as well. Okay, what I did in this video is three looks with a very, very colorful palette that you will have seen by the title, the Zulu palette by Juvia's Place. This kind of became my nemesis, I'm not gonna lie, because this is such a colorful palette, but that brown in here is a warm tone brown, and every time I kind of want to pair it with something other than the yellow and the orange, it kind of turned a little bit orange, for me at least. So yeah, I do think that I have succeeded in creating three very, very pretty looks. At least I think they are very, very pretty. Let me know down below if you have a favorite. And yeah, this is the last look that I did with this palette. Would you think that this came out of here? Let me know down below. I am very, very curious. But yeah, it's one of my favorite palettes, and it still is because I love the color story so much. But it was kind of a challenge to not do full-on colorful looks, for me at least, with this palette. So yeah, timestamps for the different looks will be down in the description box, as will the makeup that I have on my face for all the looks. The base makeup will be the same throughout the entire video. Everything will be listed down in the description box. And I will also list the playlist for this neutral series. Grab a drink, grab a snack, put your feet up, because here comes look number one. I want to focus on the yellow today. So I'm going to start with that. But first, I'm actually going to set my eyeshadow primer. I know, it's shocking, but I know how these shadows work when I don't set my base, but I want that softness, you know? So I'm going to set my eyeshadow base. I'm just grabbing my face powder, and I'm going to concentrate my setting on the upper lid. I'm kind of leaving my crease alone, because that is where I do need that stickiness. Yeah, I'm just going to use this brush for the yellow. And that's going to go all over my lid and in the crease. The reason I'm using this brush is because I don't want it too bright right off the get-go, but whatever. So here I'm just tapping it on because I haven't set my base there. I'm just going to blend it upwards a little. And if I need more, I will get more. It's also going over my lid and underneath my eye. Cute. Now I am grabbing my smaller brush, my Morphe M506, into the brown. I'm going to bring some definition back to the eye. I have here a flat, very flat brush. I'm going to go into the brown. I'm going to stamp this underneath my eye, close to the lash line. And I'm also going to stamp it on my upper lash line. I don't think I'm going to wear eyeliner, but I will probably tight line. Okay, now I'm just going to make sure that it flows nicely here. A little bit of the brown. Cute. I kind of like that, actually. I don't really know how neutral that is, but I still like it anyway. I do, however, want me a shimmer, and I want to use the pink that is in this palette, but I'm going to use it with a fluffy brush. So this is the Soft Definer, the 227 from Jessup. I'm going to go into the pink shimmer, this one. Probably going to create fallout, but yeah. Going to dust it over lightly at first, and maybe build it up if I want to. Because it has a golden shift, it does have a pink base, but it has a golden shift, you can really play with it. Here I want a little bit extra, so instead of really tapping off my brush, I'm going to leave some on. I'm just going to press it on top here. I like that. So yeah, let me get a yellow eye pencil. I have one from Essence. It looks very neon, but it's actually okay. Okay, inner corner highlight. Let me get my Revolution Skin Finish. And that is it so far for this eye. So I'm going to do the same on that eye. Put on mascara and then show you the look just before I put on my falsies. So hold on tight, don't go anywhere. Mascara is on and here is, oh yeah, and the sweater and the earrings. So here is the look just before the falsies. What I'm going to do now is falsies and the lippy. So let me do that and then I will be back and show you the finished look. Everything is on and here is the finished look. I did end up using a tiny bit of eyeliner to help hide the lash band a little bit. These falsies that I have on are kind of a little bit older, so sometimes I need a little bit extra help. So just right above and on top of the falsie band, I put a little bit of eyeliner and then a tiny bit here in the inner corner to make them tie in together. For lippy, I used the lip tonic from Kaleidos in the color Infusion, which is basically my lips but better. It is a bit pinker, and I thought it would kind of help, I don't know, keep it a little bit soft. And every day I could wear a dark purple lip with this, but I thought let's not. So yeah, let me know down below what you think of this look and let's get ready for the next one. Okay, another look with the Zulu palette. First off, I already primed my eyes, but I'm kind of going to dust a little bit of extra powder. Just a pressed face powder here. And I'm going to leave my crease area alone. What did I have in mind again? Oh yeah, I'm going to start with the brown. I had something in mind, but yeah. I'm going to start with a fluffy brush. The same brush I used to kind of dust over the powder. And I'm just going to, well, basically dust over the brown. Then I'm going to blend the edge here a little bit. Taking a little bit of face powder though. It does not matter which face powder you use. Just the one that you like. That is the first wash down. I'm going to go to a smaller brush, still in the brown, because I kind of want to give it a little bit more definition in the crease. I'm going to connect it. And I want it underneath my eye. Back to the first brush and just make sure that everything is nice and blended. Okay, what was my planning? I wanted to do something with the green and I wanted to do something with the purple. So what I'm going to do, and that one's going to go in my inner corner, I think. I'm going to fill in my lid with the brown. I'm going to go over with the first brush just to kind of blend everything. And I love these kinds of looks with just different pops of color. Today I am kind of, I know I have teal earrings in, but I'm going to change them up later. However, I already did kind of a pop of teal in my first video that I did in this series. So I'm actually grabbing the green here and it's going to go in my inner corner. I'm going to spray it. And this is so simple, but I really, really like looks like this. A little bit underneath my tear duct. I changed my mind. I actually wanted to use the purple today as well, but I think I'm not going to. I think I'm going to leave it as is and put in a green eye pencil. It's not completely the same green. This is a bit darker, but it's okay. It is darker. So I am just grabbing a small brush in that shimmery green. I'm going to dust it over a bit. Cute. I do want the brown a little bit darker. So I'm grabbing a flat brush into the brown. Now, what I want kind of a little bit of a shimmer on my eye, but I don't want to use the palette. So I'm actually grabbing my Kiko Milano Skin Finish. This is the Waterflower Magic Perfecting Powder. I could also grab my Revolution Skin Finish, but I actually want to see what this one does. It gives a very subtle sheen without changing the base color, because this has no shift, it's just translucent. So yeah, I think this is it so far, which is pretty quick. I'm going to put on liner and mascara, and then I will be back to show you the look just before the falsies. So, mascara and liner is on. My eyes are a bit annoyed with me, but yeah, I cannot do anything about it just yet. Here is the look just before the falsies. And I don't do wings, I do tails. So they are either whale tails or plain tails. Today there are more plain tails. So yeah. If you want to know how I do that, there's a tutorial down in the description box. I'm going to put on my falsies now, which is also linked down in the description box how I do that. And then I will choose a lippy and I will be back to show you the finished look. So everything is on and here is the finished look. Very nice and simple, very quick, and I really like that pop of color. I do have to say though that this brown, while I like the color, I find that I gravitate more towards the cooler tones. I think the cooler tones are prettier, at least now, for me. So yeah, this was the second look, the second neutral look with the Zulu palette. I think I'm going to do one more. But I need to think about that one a little bit, because yeah, I could do a pop of inner corner color to my heart's content, but I kind of want to use the purple as well. So I'm going to think about how I'm going to incorporate that, but you will see that in just a second. For now, let me tell you about the lippy. I want something a little bit warmer, so I needed to search, because yeah, I have more neutral and cooler browns in my collection as well, and I didn't want to do an orange. So yeah, I ended up picking the Essence Instacare lipstick in the color Sandy Sunrise. That one is very comfortable, but also a little bit more with an orange base. So yeah, I really like it. Let me know down below what you think of it, and let's get ready for look number three. The last look with the Zulu palette in this video, and it is kind of becoming my nemesis. And why am I saying that? Because I want to, I don't know, I'm having a hard time coming up with purely neutral looks with this palette. I think for me, the neutral looks that I would do with this palette, I kind of have already done. So what I would do is the brown all over the lid, and then one of these two in my inner corner or lower lash line, you know, and then kind of play with the colors or do a yellow look. That is basically what I would do with this palette if I am going to go a little bit on the neutrally side. However, I kind of do want to play with the colors today as well. And I think I'm just going, maybe I'm going to use the brown, the orange and the purple. But I'm not sure yet. Let me just, I don't know, guys. Let me start by putting the orange all over the lid. I think I'm going to start with that. So I'm going to, yeah, all over the lid and then kind of blend it out in the crease. I'm going to start like that because I have no freaking idea anymore. Oh, why do I have green on my nose? Really? Wow. That is not a sexy look at all. But yeah. So please let me know down in the comment section what you consider to be neutral shades. Because I need help, people. Okay, let me get a fluffier brush in the orange. Because I kind of want it a little bit higher up, that orange. And then I'm probably going to deepen up the crease with the brown. Okay, so that's pretty vibrant orange, isn't it? Yes, well, I'm going to grab a smaller brush. I'm going to go into the brown. I'm going to deepen up the crease and the outer corner. That's why I kind of left the spot open there. And also, it is not my favorite brown shade. The undertone of this brown is not the way that I kind of like my browns. But, you know, I did not really know that. for me a brown was a brown, but it is not. And I kind of knew it was not. Just the same as for someone who is not into purples, for instance, all the purples are kind of the same, you know? They're not. Same as with browns, and I'm learning that now, so that's nice. It's a very warm toned look, this. So I'm going to go back to the first brush to blend everything together. I can do a purple lower lash. I'm really liking that, you know, a kind of a neutral or even a brown or a very light upper part and then a defined crease, but then a darker color underneath my eye. I really, really like that. So let's do that with the purple, because I want to use the purple today. So yes, sue me. So I'm grabbing the purple matte on a pencil brush. And these two kind of complement each other, but they don't really mix. Or at least not the orange and the purple don't really want to mix. It turns a very nasty browny color. It should kind of work with the brown, but I'm not sure how much. So I'm going to pull a little bit in the outer corner here to connect it up a bit. And I don't know how well they want to play together, because we have a purple and a warm tone brown. It could very well be that they kind of make a pukey baby, but let's get a different brush. Grabbing a little bit of the purple and a little bit of the brown. Let's see what happens when I put that here. I have no idea. Could very well be that it will look like I've been punched in the eye, but that will not be the first time. It kind of does something, I just don't really know what. So I'm going back into the brown again. I'm not hating that combination. It kind of makes it a little bit muddy, but that is kind of what I want as well. So I'm going to into the purple and then in the brown again. And it now makes kind of a darker, muddier, but also cooler tone brown. And that's the kind of brown that I like. So I'm actually very happy that I did this, because I learned something. So if you want, are like me and you have this palette, but you are missing that grungier brown, that dirtier brown, combine the brown and the purple. Lightly though. I think this is actually pretty cute. Let me get a purple eye pencil. I kind of like this. The pencil that I use is actually a lip pencil from Catrice that I use for my eyes. Not for my lips, but for my eyes. It's a velvet matte color and contour in the color Tasty Aubergine. And this is a very, I don't know if it is a brown or purple. It's a very deep shade, but it actually, I think, complements this look very, very nicely. So yeah, that is very cool. I do kind of want a shimmeriness going on my lid. Let's do that. I have an idea. I don't know if it's going to be a fun idea, but I have an idea nonetheless. I'm grabbing something off a pencil brush thingy. I should it. I'm going to go into the pink. I'm going to spray it and I'm going to concentrate it here. And then probably fade it out a little bit on top of the lid. I'm going to pull a little bit onto the lash line to grab that shimmer without kind of changing the base color of the orange. I think this is very pretty. I want it here as well. Underneath my eye, underneath my tear duct, and a little bit pulled on top of the purple. And then just kind of fade over a little bit to get a little bit of that sparkle there. I kind of like how this is turning out, actually. What I am going to do, I want the inner corner a little bit more. Yes, I have here a champagne-y highlighter. It does not matter which one, it is a champagne-y highlighter. And a little bit here to lighten up the inner part. Cute. I'm going to do the same on the other eye. And then put on liner and mascara. And then I will be back to show you the look just before the falsies. Mascara and liner is on, and here is the look just before the falsies. I like it. I like the liner kind of helps tie in the darker bottom lash line. I like that personally, but you obviously don't have to follow exactly in my footsteps. So yeah, I have an itchy nose. What I'm going to do now is put on my falsies and choose lippy. And then I will be back to show you the finished look. And we can close off the video at the same time. So hold on tight, don't go anywhere. Yeah, this is the finished look. I was going to say something, but I don't know what. Wow. I really like how the look turned out. I paired it with a Catrice Generation Matte Comfort Matte in the color Muddy Madness, and that is maybe even my perfect nude. I'm not sure. It's kind of a neutrally nude, I think, but I like it. It's very comfortable. I think it's pretty and it goes well with the look. So yeah, this was the last look of my neutral looks with the Zulu palette. Let me know if you think I succeeded. Let me know if you have a favorite. And yeah, this palette kind of became my nemesis a little bit, creating neutral looks, just because I found out that that brown in here is not my preferred brown tone. Yes. However, I did learn that if I pair it with the purple, it does become my perfect brown tone. So yeah, I learned something with this palette. I hope you did too. I hope you had as much fun watching as I did creating the looks. Granted, there was a little bit of frustration at times on my part. I'm not going to lie about that. But I think I kind of nailed it in the end anyway. So yeah, I'm going to stop rambling. Thank you so much for watching, and if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I will see you very, very soon in my next one. Bye guys!